we're going to Target. Is that where we're going?
Yeah.
We're going to Target. Oh, don't mind our Christmas music, because it's almost Christmas. Who do you have with you?
It's Emma and Funifun.
Baby Sarah and your Funifun.
And Emma and Papa Fah. And all the flowers.
She's become obsessed with these little flowers that in her bathroom for her hair. It's really funny. But yes, happy Tuesday to you guys. Oh, my glasses are crooked. I'm always on Team Ratchet with my glasses. They're always bent and crooked. We are in Target. Oh, more tricks. Okay, keep going, sweetie. Just spontaneous tricks, huh? They're so pretty. What, sweetie? Oh, yeah, that's a whole bunch of stuff we don't need, though. Come on, let's go this way. We gotta go this way. Guys, we go to Walmart a lot, but I'm just gonna be honest, Target is where it's at. Oh, look at the shoes, Audrey. Should we go look at the shoes really quick? Oh, my gosh, guys. Okay, so I got a pair of shoes just like this, and I wore them out. And this is like a felt kind of, does anyone know how to clean that material? They got really dirty and I don't know how to clean them. Look at all the slippers they have. Maybe we should do something like these. I feel like these would stay on better for you. You wanna do these? Like yeah. The one mommy has? Oh, and these are your exact size. Cute. That way when you wake up in the morning, you can have your cozy slippers and your feet won't be cold. Guys, you wanna know another thing I'm obsessed with other than mugs? Slippers. I'm like an old lady. I love slippers. Can you put them in the basket or you wanna carry them? Hey, what'd you do with Oh, you still have it. Okay. She always brings random things in. And I have to keep up with it. Hey, Bubby. Do you like riding in the cart?
It's a headband.
Oh, yeah. We don't need any more headbands. Hey, can you pick up your slippers? You can put them in the cart or you can carry them. Come on. We got to go get some wipes. We got to get wipes before your brother poops his pants.
They're right over there.
What's right over there?
Toys.
Oh, my. Well, you know what, sweetie? I don't think we're gonna do toys today.
Let's say hi to them.
You just wanna say hi to them? Well, let me get some wipes first, and then maybe we can say hi to the toys. Yeah, actually, that's a good idea, because mommy's researching what to get for Christmas, so,
Look at that, baby.
Who is that little baby? Who is that? Do you know who that is?
It's just like Kylan.
It's just like Kylan. These are the wipes we get, aren't they? Big old purple ones. Hey, do you see this little vest mommy got? It's on sale. Do you like it?
Yeah.
You think I should get it for you?
Sure.
You think it's cute?
I think.
You think?
I think.
You think? Okay.
Let's go say hi to the toys.
Well, she is about to say hi to the toys. What do you think? What is with all these scratches on your face, dude? Goodness, did you have a rough night? Did you have a rough night? What? How did you? Oh my goodness, Bubby. How did you scratch your face like that? Oh my. Oh my goodness, guys. This brings back so many memories. I had one of these as a kid. I love that thing. Marble Run. We called it Marble Works. That thing is so cool. Also, we have one of these that I found at the thrift store. Look how much it is brand new. $29.99, right? Thrift store, y'all. Check it out. Okay, Audrey. We're gonna look at toys until Mama sets the timer, and then we're going to be all done. Okay? Do you understand? Okay. You think she gets it, Kylan? You're so cute. You're already ready for your nap, aren't you? What is that?
A car seat.
Oh, it's a car seat for your baby. That's cool. Remember, we're just looking. We're just, think of it as a research project. Think of it as research, because, I mean, not saying you're gonna get all these toys for Christmas, because you're not, but. Interesting to see what you're interested in.
I'm gonna put this baby in.
You're gonna put the baby in? Huh.
I wonder if she wants to
get
out.
No, I don't think she can get out because we would have to pay for her first for her to get out. So I think she wants to just sit on the shelf and say hi to you. Hi! You know, you have a baby just like that at home, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm gonna set the timer, okay, right now. This is what we do. We set timers because it just helps them understand time. You know, they don't understand what 5 minutes means. So if you set the timer, then they can physically hear it go off. A lot of times it helps, it really does. She hears the timer and she's like, okay, I know what time's up. So many little animals. Yep, you have so many toys at home, you're right, you do. It's a motorcycle. Oh, Adriana, the timer's going off, see? Means it's time to say goodbye to toys, okay? So finish hearing the song, okay, last time, and then we're gonna go. Last time. Oh my, that's intense. Okay, say bye motorcycle, see you next time. Oh, bye motorcycle, see you next time. Good job, sweetie. Okay, mommy has to get one more thing and then we're gonna go, okay?
Good job listening.
Toys.
Can you say bye to the toys?
Bye, toys. See you later.
See you later, alligator. Okay, let's go this
bye,
way.
Bye, McDuffins. What did I got that McDuffins?
Yep, come on, sweetie. Come on, say bye to McDuck McStuffins. Say see you next time. Come on, sweetie Petey. This way. Come on. Come on. Good job.
Yeah, yes. Me,
Mom points for the win. Where are we at?
Target.
Target, but where are we at in Target?
Be quiet.
Oh, we have to be quiet? We're in Starbucks. Starbucks. We're just hanging out. Kylan, what on earth are you doing?
Mama.
What are you doing?
Upstairs.
You're upstairs. And this kid always trying to climb through something. Hey, show everyone your bum though. So I got him these leggings off of Zulily. Look at how cute his little bum looks in them. When I first ordered them, I was like, yeah, he's got an airplane bum. I wasn't really sure because I'm like, I don't know if boys should wear leggings, but yeah, they're so cute. They make your bum look even bigger than it already is, and that's adorable. Hey, what are you doing? What are you doing? Why are you always trying to fit under things? Oh, it's a pink cookie? Thank you. Can I eat it? Does it have sprinkles?
Yes.
Oh, yes, it does. Can I have a bite? Oh, no, you decided not to share?
Here I go, Mama. You can have
it. Thank you, sweetie.
Okay,
you're going to get one, too? Okay, just keep these up here, away from Kylan, okay? What are you doing? You crazy boy. You're always climbing through something. Kylan, can you say hi? Kylan, say
Mama.
Hi.
Here you go, Mama.
He's so busy. Oh, thank you. Another one. Oh, my heck. Uh-oh, you dropped your toy. How do you plan to get out of here? That's what I would like to know. Oh, careful. Uh-oh, I think you're stuck. How are you going to get out? Do you need help? Are you stuck? I think you need help. Oh my gosh. yeah, I think you're stuck. That's funny. Cute.
Alright guys, so I just had to go run a couple errands, but now I'm getting Brittany a little special something, okay? Because she deserves something nice, okay? Just a little something. I'm gonna get her a magazine, some flowers, and some candy. Even though we have candy for Halloween. But maybe I'll get her something special. I don't know. I'll get her some Tate's cookies. I don't know. Is that a thing? Is that cool? What's something cool you get your wife? I think she likes chocolate. She loves chocolate. Maybe I'll get her Oreos. You can never go wrong with Oreos. Like, the quickest way to a woman's heart is just to give her Oreos. And then, like, you put them on her heart. But that's inappropriate, because then that might be on her breast. Anyways, I don't know what I'm saying.
Oh, cool, winter Oreos. Oh, I'm gonna get her those, because that's so cute. And then I'll play her Christmas music.
Yes. Okay, I'm gonna get her these, winter Oreos. Now I need to get her, I'll get her a card too. Some flowers. It's good to try and go out of your way to do something romantic for your wife, you know? So I want to try and think of something cool and give her something special. Give her a nice little magazine to read while she's pooping. Okay, that's not romantic. I need to shut up. So we just got a bunch of cool stuff in the mail. First of all, we got this book. This is called 52nd, The 52nd, and it is by, if you guys know my friend Mr. Arturo Trejo, he's a hilarious YouTuber, but his sister-in-law, she goes by De La. That's her name, her writer name, De La. She wrote this book. It's like a YA novel. Driving home one night, college freshman Zara Moss swerves to avoid hitting a ghastly figure in the road. Lucas Castillo witnesses the car crash, but when it comes time to supervise her abduction from the wreckage, he intervenes. Something is different about Zara. Lucas has been having dreams of her arrival for 500 years. She sent it to us to read and to tell you guys about. So if you want to check it out, I'll put the link to her website down below. If you're into YA novels, you guys will probably love it for sure. Also, we just got our blue apron, and I am about to go ham because look at all the goodness. Look at it. Look at all the stuff. Ooh, the chicken knickknacks. Ew, all right. If you guys don't know what Blue Apron is, it's a ballin' outrageous service. We actually work with them. And so they send us food, right? And so The way it works is they'll send you 3 meals.
Like this week we got, I'm actually about to make this, congee and caramelized pork with crispy shallots of black garlic. This is actually a special one. I didn't even realize that they do this, but it's called Guest Chef Series. This chick, she won Top Chef, and this was the winning dish in season 12. I'm actually about to make it right now. And then we got Greek style braised chicken thighs, which looks good, with some fingerling potatoes, pan-seared salmon, arugula. Oh man, yeah, so
we got some legit stuff.
All right, so I got all my ingredients and everything. The nice thing about Blue Apron is that they send you everything like it's all just already packaged, you know, like it's the right amount that you need. They call these knickknacks, basically just a bunch of little things that you need, like little sauces or extra things, garlic, you know, flour, all this stuff. Black garlic, I didn't know that was a thing, but yeah. So it's cool, it's all packaged for you and it you know, comes out to make the right amount. And so then once you know that you have everything, right, you have all the ingredients, you just go to the back. They just show you the step-by-step process on how to make it, which is perfect for me because I'm kind of a fool when it comes to cooking.
Just so you guys know though, if you want to try these meals, because literally every time we get these meals, we try new things and it's so freaking good. You guys can actually use our link down below, blueapron.com/9Nulls, and you get your first 2 meals free, okay? The way it works is each meal is $9.99 per person, but with our link, you get 2 free meals. So that's pretty legit, right? $20 value, can't argue with that. And the meals are so good and so tasty, but they're also like, you know, this one, I think this meal's only like 700 calories. Yeah, 700 calories per serving. Like it's really good, you know, healthy stuff. Not to mention it's easy, and it's easier than eating out sometimes too. You know, you just get all that food sent to you, you just have to cook it real quick and boom, there you go. You have a ballin' outrageous gourmet meal. So yeah, blueapron.com/9Nulls, get 2 meals free. And I'm about to make this mug right now. Let's do it.
All right, it's coming along pretty nice. I got all of my ingredients and I'm about to do this rice. It's going right now. Apparently you put it in with the seasoning and mix it all together. And now I'm about to add some water. And it's like a rice porridge kind of thing, which I thought only bears ate porridge or something. Wasn't there a story about that? Toasting up this pork right quick. It's gonna be really, really nice. What are you two cuties doing, eh? You're just laying there like cuties?
She's still waking up. Wait, what?
We have our periods, just kidding.
Well, one of them does, that's for sure.
I'm gonna make this meal and only probably me, maybe Brittany will eat it.
I'll eat it.
You'll eat it?
It's not enough for everyone anyway.
Yeah, me and Brittany are gonna eat it.
All right, so I got the meat done. I'm frying some shallots, got the little porridge rice thing done.
It's about to go down
and then I'm gonna garnish it with some scallions and I believe it's parsley.
Parsley, I think, yeah. Hey, what are you doing?
I'm eating pasta.
You're eating pasta up here?
Yeah.
Oh, no way.
Dad, that doesn't know what to me. That's not nice.
What'd she say?
Don't say no way to me. That's not nice.
She's just calling us over.
Dad, don't be nice, Dad.
Hey, don't be nice? Okay, fine.
Hey, you need to eat your pasta.
You need to eat your pasta. Quit telling me what to do. I'm Dada. I'm the one in charge.
I'm the one who knocks.
Dada, you're not charge.
I am in charge. I'm your daddy.
Dada, you're not charge.
Is mommy in charge or is daddy in charge?
Who's in charge?
Kylan's
in charge? All right, fair enough. All right, here it is, the final product. You got like this porridge looking rice and then the pork and then the sauteed scallions, or what are they called? I don't know what they're called. Basically they're onions, and I fried them, and I put them on, and then you put on like cilantro, and some green onions.
I ran out of food.
Anyway, oh my glory, really, guys, this kid.
Oh no, I ran out of food.
Are you kidding me?
Sorry.
You got it.
I'm getting more.
That's only because he's mad that he doesn't have food. Literally nothing is wrong with him. Look at him. Look at him. Oh my glory. This kid, guys, sometimes we say, oh, Audrey's dramatic. No, this kid is dramatic. Anyways, yes, so this is about to be amazing. I'm about to smash this. And shout out to Blue Apron for hooking us up with it. Once again, get your 2 free meals with blueapron.com/9Nulls down below. And let me know what you guys think about it because I for one think it's pretty delicious. So looking forward to hearing what you have to say.
So I'm sitting here reading on the internet and I remembered I need to tell you guys a couple things. I put up an extra video today. If you haven't seen it yet, we did that Jimmy Kimmel prank where you tell your kid that you ate all their Halloween candy. We did that with Audrey.
Oh, it was cute. So that link to that video is down below. I just put it up as its own extra video. Also, I'm in a documentary that a kid, a guy named Jonathan Godfrey, he made a little documentary about YouTubers, and I'm in it. He asked me to be in it and answer questions, and I did. So the link to that YouTube documentary is down below as well. You should go check it out. Show it some love. I believe I start around 30-minute mark, somewhere around there. I don't know, but you should watch all the other ones. They're cool. Now I'm just, I'm just on the internet. Guys, what do you do? So, like, late at night, all right? Like, right now, Brittany, she's upstairs. She's having me time, okay? Sometimes you gotta have me time. I think she's watching Law & Order SVU. She's so freaking cute. I am, I was catching up on emails. I'm on Twitter. This, let's see, right now, LC Young just said, that vlog was packed full of awesomeness. She's talking about the vlog that went up yesterday, which if you didn't see, it was like 20 minutes of, you know, crazy weekend awesome footage. So go check that out. But yeah, I'm just on Twitter. I'm on Facebook. I'm on Tumblr. I'm on all the cool social networks, okay? I'm so hip. Also, I don't know. I feel like, should I talk about this? Probably not. So here's the deal, guys. I'm gonna just be 100 with y'all, cause y'all know that like I don't really like mess around or hold it back. So I always I search the internet for a name. Okay, I just like to see what people are saying. You know, like you never know. And also, I think it's good to know, like, you know, what if people are saying really weird things? What if we should know about it, report it, something like that? So I'll search our name. And there's like blogs that will like, you know, write things about us from time to time. And they're like the most entertaining things I've ever read. I just think it's fun. It's basically like YouTube comments, you know, like whenever people have really crazy YouTube comments. But there's like whole blogs apparently that will talk about you too. I mean, if you're watching, you peeps, what up? It's just funny to me, like, we're on the internet, okay? You guys know that our whole life is on the internet. But I understand that there's a massive disconnect between the internet and real life. You guys probably look at our life and you think, man, I totally know your life. And you know parts of it. You know about 15 minutes of our day out of a 24-hour day. You do know that. I will give you that. But really, like, there's a lot of things that, like, I don't know. It's just funny. Like, you can't... My one advice to all people that watch YouTube, because I even used to do this some. Like, I would watch other YouTubers and be like, oh, man. You know, like, you think things. But then, like, I'll either meet a person in real life or I just learn from my own experience, like, you can't base, you cannot understand a person just by watching 15 minutes of their day. It's just impossible. And also, you have to remember, YouTubers are gonna show pretty much the best parts, okay? Like, when I put up our life, right, I'm putting up kind of, it's not scripted, but it's the coolest parts of the day. Or it's just very selective, you know? Like, there's definitely times where like, Brittany and I will, like, vlog, and we're like, ah, hilarious, but then right after or right before we were like, you know, in an argument, or we were talking about something, you know, really like deep, or you know what I mean, like we're not always sharing things. I don't know, it's just funny. The blogs that I read are always entertaining, like, because I think it's funny to hear what people think, like, and they say things so matter-of-factly. Like, I've seen the most insightful comments into my life, and I didn't know anything about it. I was like,
oh, really? I do think that way, apparently. That makes sense.
And also, Alex from Target is still number one trending. Why? Like, this makes me hate the internet. Really, it does. Anyways, thanks for watching. You guys rock. We'll see you tomorrow for another video. Deuces.